Hello everyone, welcome to the Civil Engineering Department. I am Pavitra Bhatt from MJ Polytechnic. In this video, we are going to study subject Railway, Harbour and Tunnel Engineering. This session is focused on tunnel lining and ventilation. In this video, we will discuss about introduction of tunnel lining, objectives of tunnel lining, requirements of an ideal lining, types of lining, tunnel ventilation, requirements of ventilating system, and last, methods of ventilation. Let's start with our first topic, tunnel lining. So what is tunnel lining? The finishing touch gives to the cross section of tunnel is termed as tunnel lining. These are the permanent or temporary support for keeping tunnels from collapse and provide safety. Tunnel lining may be divided into two parts, temporary lining and permanent. The next topic is objectives of tunnel lining. It withstands soil pressure in soil soft soil. It provides strength to the weakened soft section in the tunnel. It gives correct section to the tunnel. It protects certain types of rocks from air slipping. Reduce water friction against the wall. It reduces the maintenance cost of tunnel. And last, supports the loose rock pieces during blast. Now let's talk about what is the requirement of an ideal tunnel. The main basic requirement for a tunnel lining are: it should be economical, should be stable, durable, easy to construct and maintain. Next topic is types of lining. Various types of lining are shown in this chart. First, timber lining, iron lining, steel lining, brick lining, stone masonry lining and last, concrete and RCC lining. Further, we will discuss types of lining one by one in detail. First, timber lining. Timber lining is used as temporary lining which is replaced by cement concrete or any other types of lining. Timber lining is cheaper and construction is easy. Disadvantages of timber lining are this liability decay, timber has fire hazards, it cannot be used where water percolates. Second, iron lining. The use of iron lining was introduced during construction of a tunnel under river Thames in England. For shield-driven tunnels, cast iron lining proves to be useful. It can attain full strength immediately after placing in position. Iron lining can be effectively waterproof by suitable smooth form and at joint between the segments. Third, steel lining. It is also used as a primary lining for ships. Due to higher cost, use is limited. Fourth, brick lining. It was the standard material for tunnel lining, but it is now rapidly going out of use, except in the case of underground sewer, as bricks are more and acid resistance. Fifth, stone masonry. Stone lining become very heavy. However, stone masonry is used in sidewalls occasionally. Stone masonry has more or less same advantages as brick masonry. Sixth, concrete and RCC lining. Cement concrete has become the standard material of tunnel lining in both rock and soft soil. Reinforcement in lining is required where the tensile stress in a lining exceeds the allowable limit of the lining material. Its main advantage lies in the plasticity, which allow to be well packed between the form and the soil. It is watertight and provides smooth surface. Our second topic in this session is tunnel ventilation. What do you mean by tunnel ventilation? Ventilation means technique of providing fresh air inside the tunnel during and after construction. Requirements of tunnel lining or tunnel ventilation. During construction, it is necessary to ventilate a tunnel for various reasons like to furnish fresh air for the workers, to remove the dust caused by drilling, blasting, mucking, diesel engine and other operations, to remove gas and fumes produced by explosives, to reduce temperature in tunnel situated at great depth. There are mainly two types of tunnel ventilation. First, natural ventilation and second, mechanical ventilation. In mechanical ventilation, there are three types: blowing, exhausting, and last one is combination of blowing and exhausting. In this video, we have taken a basic idea about tunnel lining and ventilation. I hope you have gone through the video session thoroughly. Now it's time to evaluate yourself as how much you understood the concept of tunnel lining and ventilation. You all are requested to attempt the quiz prepared for this topic. Just click in the link given in the description to start the quiz. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Agency Civil. Thank you so much for watching this video.